not the wetness of the Spirit, but also not the blueness of the Spirit. The scientists have learned that red flames correspond to temperatures from 980 degrees Fahrenheit to 1800 degrees Fahrenheit. Flames enter orange when the temperature is 2000 degrees to 1200 degrees. Then when the temperature reaches 2400 to 2700 degrees Fahrenheit, flames appear white. Did you know that when the temperature reaches 2600 to 3000 degrees Fahrenheit, are the flames of the Spirit reaching their hottest level? The blue flames, blue as the water we see behind us. Here people walking all over the place. Maybe next year we should consider wearing not only red, but blue. For the Spirit is not only fine, the Spirit is also fine. Still, when I ask the question, like, why did Jesus describe the Spirit as water here? Perhaps the legendary Chinese-American martial artist, philosopher, and filmmaker Bruce Lee, who decides to lie on the matter. At the peak of his career, before losing it, Bruce Lee started in his four episodes of his short-lived TV series called Strong Streets, where he delivered his famous metaphor. He said, empty your mind. Formless, shapeless, like water. If you put water into a cup, it becomes a cup. If you put water into a bottle, it becomes a bottle. If you put it into a teapot, it becomes a teapot. Now water can flow, or it can crush. Water. See the sense that the Spirit is water, that it is formless, shapeless, flowing like rivers of living water in us. Then should we not embody that Spirit? Should we not personify the Spirit, exemplify the Spirit, represent the Spirit? Be water by the Spirit. The Spirit that comes into us, becomes in us, dwells in us. Scripture says that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you. And is this not the wisdom for us this morning? Shall we not pause here and allow the wisdom to settle and land in us? Wisdom from thousands and thousands and thousands of years ago arrives at the very front of us this morning. And if we claim to be part of this holy Trinitarian flow, that if we claim to be part of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, part of the Creator, Redeemer, and Sustainer, who was, who is, and who is to come, then should we not be like one? Then, what I see and hear and read about the American Christian Church, many of my dear siblings in Christ, grappling to be water, grappling to be spirits. You see, I can speak about this church. I can speak about my church because I was part of the church. I grew up in the church. I've been a part of this church. My ancestors have served this church. I was baptized in this church, became a clergy in this church, a pastor of this church, evangelical, Pentecostal, Lutheran, Baptist, Methodist, Reformed. I know this church really well. Historical points of black and brown and indigenous people of color 400 years wasn't enough. Holy Spirit. Christian groups and organizations that I see will stand up on the sidelines and silence and criticize. As violent people and children are being abused and excluded and humiliated, and our church be watered in spirit, formless and shameless. Christian groups and organizations who purposely are enacting bills and laws that attack the prisons or are personally, especially transgender people. Sharing one's message rather than pouring it.